Dear student, previous class we discussed about the find A, B, C, D type conversion related to the aromatic amine. Today I will discuss about the conversion related to the aliphatic amine. I will solve this type of conversion. At first I will convert the methyl amine to ethyl amine. It is one type of ascending type of conversion. Ascending type of conversion. For this type of conversion, generally we use some basic reaction, that is your Wood's reaction, reaction between KCN, reaction with Grignard's reagent, reaction with Grignard's reagent, Frankland reaction. Generally we use reaction with KCN in most of the cases. It is a one type of ascending type of conversion. At first I will write the formula of methyl amine. This is the formula of methyl amine. CH3NH2 is the formula of methyl amine. The formula of ethyl amine is your C2H5NH2. Look at that, there is your one carbon atom present, your two carbon atom present. So it is a one type of ascending type of conversion. Suppose I will want to use the reaction with KCN. We know that KCN react with alkyl halide. So at first, suppose I will take, this is your methyl chloride. Methyl chloride when subjected to reaction with alcoholic KCN, then methyl cyanide is formed. Look at that, there is an increase in the number of carbon atom. Your one carbon atom is present, but your two carbon atom is present. Now the cyanide is converted into amine. It can be possible by the help of reduction. So when methyl cyanide undergoes reduction, then ethyl amine is formed. Now our aim to convert the methyl amine to methyl chloride. This can be possible by the help of reaction with HNO2. When methyl amine is subjected to reaction with HNO2, then it converted into methyl alcohol. Now methyl alcohol when subjected to reaction with SOCl2, then methyl chloride is formed. Look at that. This is your methyl amine when subjected to reaction with HNO2, then methyl alcohol is formed. And methyl alcohol when subjected to reaction with SOCl2, then methyl chloride is formed. Again methyl chloride subjected to reaction with alcoholic KCN, then methyl cyanide is formed. Now methyl cyanide undergoes reduction gives ethyl amine. Now I will solve the question number 2. The question number 2 is your ethyl amine to methyl amine. Ethyl amine to methyl amine. This is one type of descending type of reaction. Suppose I want to apply the Schmidt's reaction. For this conversion, at first I will write the formula of ethyl amine. The formula of ethyl amine is your C2H5NH2. The formula of methyl amine is your CH3NH2. Look at that. There is a decrease in the number of carbon atom. Here two carbon atom, here one carbon atom. Suppose I will apply the Schmidt's reaction. We know that Schmidt's reaction generally done by the help of carboxylic acid and hydrogenic acid. For such type of conversion, suppose I will take the acetic acid
and it is subjected to reaction with the hydrogenic acid
and it is done in the presence of H2SO4. Here heat is given, then acetic acid is converted into methyl amine. Now our aim to convert the ethyl amine into acetic acid. So at first I will convert the ethyl amine to alcohol. This can be possible by the help of reaction with HNO2. When ethyl amine undergoes reaction with HNO2, then ethyl alcohol is formed. Now this ethyl alcohol undergoes oxidation, gives acetic acid, and acetic acid undergoes reaction with hydrogenic acid in the presence of H2SO4. Heat is given, then ethyl amine is formed. Look at again, ethyl amine when subjected to reaction with HNO2, देन इथाइल अल्कोहल इज फॉर्म देन इथाइल अल्कोहल अंडरगोज ऑक्सीडेशन एट फर्स्ट एसिटाइलडिहाइड इज फॉर्म व्हिच ऑन फर्दर ऑक्सीडेशन गिव्स एसिटिक एसिड नाउ द एसिटिक एसिड अंडरगोज रिएक्शन विद हाइड्रोजोइक एसिड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ H2SO4 हीट इज गिवन देन मिथाइल एमीन इज फॉर्म नाउ आई विल डू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 इज योर इथानोइक एसिड टू मिथानामाइन सपोज आई विल अप्लाई द सिमिट्स रिएक्शन फॉर दिस कन्वर्सन वी नो द सिमिट्स रिएक्शन इज जनरली अप्लाइड टू द कार्बोसिलिक एसिड व्हिच इज ट्रीटेड विथ हाइड्रोजोइक एसिड Your carboxylic acid is already given. The formula of ethanoic acid is your CH3COH. The formula of methyl amine, that is your methanamine, is your CH3NH2. Now, ethanoic acid is subjected to reaction with the hydrogenic acid. In the presence of H2SO4, heat is given. Then, methyl amine is formed. This is a very simple conversion. Now, I will do the question number 4. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज योर मिथानामाइन टू इथानोइक एसिड टू इथानोइक एसिड इट इज वन टाइप ऑफ एसेंडिंग टाइप ऑफ कन्वर्सन सपोज आई विल अप्लाई द रिएक्शन विथ KCN एट फर्स्ट आई विल राइट द फॉर्मूला ऑफ मिथानामाइन दैट इज योर CH3NH2 द फॉर्मूला ऑफ इथानोइक एसिड इज योर CH3COH Suppose I will apply the reaction with the KCN. The KCN react with the alkyl halide. So at first our aim to convert the methyl amine into methyl chloride. This can be done by the following reaction. At first methyl amine is subjected to reaction with the HNO2. Then what will happen? Methyl alcohol is formed. Now methyl alcohol is subjected to reaction with the SOCl2. Then methyl alcohol react with SOCl2. Then methyl chloride is formed. Now apply the reaction with the KCN. Then methyl chloride react with the alcoholic KCN. Then methyl cyanide is formed. And methyl cyanide undergoes acid hydrolysis from the acetic acid, that is ethanoic acid. Again I will repeat. Methyl amine subjected to reaction with HNO2. Methyl alcohol is formed. Methyl alcohol when subjected to reaction with SOCl2. Then methyl chloride is formed. Then methyl chloride is subjected to reaction with the alcoholic KCN. Then methyl cyanide is formed. Methyl cyanide when undergoes acid hydrolysis, then ethanoic acid is formed. That is, acetic acid is formed. Next, I will do the conversion number 5. The conversion number 5 is your ethyl amine to ethyl acetate. The formula of ethyl amine is your C2H5NH2. The formula of ethyl acetate is your CH3COOC2H5. At first, I will convert the ethyl amine to ethyl alcohol by reacting with HNO2. That means when ethyl amine subjected to reaction with HNO2, then ethyl alcohol is formed. Now, ethyl alcohol is subjected to reaction with the acetic acid in the presence of concentrated H2SO4, that is your H+, is given. Or you can write concentrated H2SO4. Again, I will repeat. Ethyl amine subjected to reaction with HNO2. Ethyl alcohol is formed. Ethyl alcohol when subjected to reaction with acetic acid, then ethyl ethanoate is formed. That is otherwise also called ethyl acetate. Next, I will solve the question number 6. Ethyl acetate to ethyl amine. Ethyl acetate to ethyl amine. Ethyl acetate to ethyl amine. The formula of ethyl acetate is CH3COOC2H5. This is the formula of ethyl acetate. The formula of ethylamine is C2H5NH2. Ethyl acetate when undergoes reduction, then ethyl alcohol is formed. Now ethyl alcohol is subjected to reaction with the NH3 in the presence of ZnCl2 at 300 degree centigrade, then ethylamine is formed. Again I will repeat, ethyl acetate undergoes reduction gives ethyl alcohol, and ethyl alcohol when subjected to reaction with the NH3 in the presence of ZnCl2 at 300 degree centigrade, then ethylamine is formed. Now I will do the question number 7. The question number 7 is ethyl alcohol to methylamine. Ethyl alcohol to methylamine. This is also one type of descending type of conversion. Suppose I will apply the Schmidt's reaction. At first I will write the formula of ethyl alcohol. The formula of ethyl alcohol is C2H5OH. The formula of methylamine is CH3NH2. Look at that. There is a degradation in the number of carbon atom. So we bound to apply the Schmidt's reaction. Schmidt's reaction generally applied to the carboxylic acid with the hydrazoic acid in the presence of H2SO4. So my first aim to convert the ethyl alcohol to acetic acid. This can be possible by the help of oxidation. When ethyl alcohol undergoes oxidation, then acetaldehyde is formed. Then on further oxidation, that is converted into acetic acid. Now acetic acid is subjected to reaction with the hydrazoic acid. In the presence of H2SO4, heat is given, then methylamine is formed. Again I will repeat, ethyl alcohol undergoes oxidation gives acetic acid, and acetic acid undergoes reaction with hydrazoic acid in the presence of H2SO4, and heat is given, then methylamine is formed. Now I will do the question number 8. The question number 8 is methylamine to ethyl alcohol. This is one type of ascending type of conversion. The formula of methylamine is CH3NH2. The formula of ethyl alcohol is C2H5OH. Suppose I will apply the
reaction with KCN, then we need the
alkyl halide. So my first aim to convert the methylamine to methyl chloride. Then I will apply the KCN reaction with methyl chloride. Then it is converted into methyl cyanide. Again methyl cyanide undergoes reduction gives the ethylamine, and ethylamine undergoes reaction with the HNO2 converted into ethyl alcohol. So my first aim, convert the methylamine to methyl chloride. This can be possible by the following reaction. At first methylamine subjected to reaction with HNO2, then methyl alcohol is formed. Now methyl alcohol is subjected to reaction with SOCl2, then methyl chloride is formed. Again I will repeat, methylamine when subjected to reaction with HNO2, methyl alcohol is formed. Now methyl alcohol subjected to reaction with SOCl2, then methyl chloride is formed. Again methyl chloride reacted with the alcoholic HCN, then methyl cyanide is formed. Methyl cyanide when undergoes reduction, then ethylamine is formed. Now ethylamine subjected to reaction with HNO2, ethyl alcohol is formed. Next I will do the question number 9. The question number 9 is your acetic acid to ethyl amine.
Acetic acid to ethyl amine.
The formula of acetic acid is your CH3COH. The formula of ethyl amine is your C2H5MH2. At first, I will convert the acetic acid into alkene. Then alkene is converted into alkyl halide. Alkyl halide is converted into alkyl amine. So acetic acid is subjected to reaction with the HI in the presence of red phosphorus. Then acetic acid undergoes complete reduction, gives you ethane. Now ethane is subjected to halogenation in the presence of HNO, then what will happen? Ethyl chloride is formed. Now ethyl chloride is subjected to reaction with the NH3, gives the ethyl amine. Again I will repeat, acetic acid undergoes reaction with the HI in the presence of red phosphorus. Your complete reduction takes place and alkene is formed, that is your ethane is formed. Now ethane is subjected to reaction with the Cl2 in the presence of sunlight, that is your HNO, then ethyl chloride is formed. Now ethyl chloride is subjected to reaction with the NH3, then ethyl amine is formed. Next I will do the question number 10. The question number 10 is your ethyl amine to acetic acid. Ethyl amine to acetic acid. The formula of ethyl amine is your C2H5NH2. The formula of acetic acid is your CH3COH. At first C2H5NH2 is converted into alcohol. It is converted into ethyl alcohol. Now ethyl alcohol when undergoes oxidation gives the acetic acid. Again I will repeat, ethyl amine when subjected to reaction with HNO2, then ethyl alcohol is formed. Now ethyl alcohol undergoes oxidation gives the acetic acid, that is your ethanoic acid. Next I will solve the question number 11. That is your methyl alcohol to ethyl amine. The formula of methyl alcohol is your CH3OH. Now it is converted into methyl chloride by reaction with the SOCl2. When methyl alcohol is subjected to reaction with the SOCl2, then methyl chloride is formed. Now methyl chloride is converted into methyl cyanide by reaction with the alcoholic HCN. Then CH3CN is formed. Again CH3CN undergoes reduction gives the ethyl amine. Again I will repeat, methyl alcohol when undergoes reaction with SOCl2, then methyl chloride is formed. When methyl chloride is subjected to reaction with alcoholic HCN, then methyl cyanide is formed, which undergoes reduction gives the ethyl amine. Next I will do the question number 12. The question number 12 is your ethyl amine to methyl alcohol. Ethyl amine to methyl alcohol. This is a one type of descending type of reaction. So we bound to apply the Hofmann's bromide reaction, Schmidt's reaction, or you can apply Dumas method. Suppose I will apply the Schmidt's reaction. At first I will write the formula of ethyl amine. The formula of ethyl amine is your C2H5NH2. The formula of methyl alcohol is your CH3OH. At first I will convert the ethyl amine to carboxylic acid, because Schmidt's reaction belongs to the carboxylic acid. So ethyl amine undergoes reaction with the HNO2 form ethyl alcohol. Now ethyl alcohol undergoes oxidation gives you acetic acid. Now acetic acid undergoes Schmidt's reaction, that is your acetic acid react with the hydrogenic acid. In the presence of H2SO4, heat is given. Then methyl amine is formed. Now methyl amine subjected to reaction with the HNO2, then methyl alcohol is formed. Again I will repeat, ethyl amine undergoes reaction with HNO2, gives the ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol undergoes oxidation, gives the acetic acid. Acetic acid undergoes Schmidt's reaction, gives the methyl amine. Methyl amine undergoes reaction with HNO2, gives the methyl alcohol. Now I will do the question number 13. The question number 13 is your methyl chloride to ethyl carbyl amine. The formula of methyl chloride is your Ca3Cl. The formula of ethyl carbyl amine is your C2H5NC. Ca3Cl is subjected to reaction with the sodium dry in the presence of dry ether. That undergoes Wood's reaction, gives the ethane. Now ethane is subjected to reaction with the chlorine in the presence of sunlight, that is HNO. Then ethyl chloride is formed. Now ethyl chloride is subjected to reaction with the alcoholic HgCN, then ethyl isocyanide is formed. Again I will repeat, methyl chloride undergoes Wood's reaction, gives the ethane. Ethane undergoes halogenation in the presence of sunlight, then ethyl chloride is formed. Ethyl chloride then undergoes the reaction with the alcoholic HgCN, then ethyl carbyl amine is formed. Now I will do the question number 14. The question number 14 is your acetic acid to methyl isocyanide. The formula of acetic acid is your what? Ca3COH. The formula of methyl isocyanide is your Ca3NC. This can be possible by the help of carbyl amine reaction, where methyl amine subjected to carbyl amine reaction, then methyl isocyanide is formed. That means methyl amine is subjected to reaction with the chloroform in the presence of alcoholic KOH, then methyl isocyanide is formed. Now I am to convert the acetic acid into methyl amine. So acetic acid is subjected to Schmidt's reaction, that means acetic acid subjected to reaction with the hydrogenic acid in the presence of H2SO4, heat is given, then it is converted into methyl amine. Next I will do the question number 15, that is your methyl bromide to ethylene. The formula of methyl bromide is your CH3Br. The formula of ethylene, that is your ethene, is your CH2 double bond CH2. This is a very simple reaction. At first, methyl bromide subjected to reaction with sodium in the presence of dry ether. That means methyl bromide undergoes Wood's reaction. Then ethane is formed. Now ethane is subjected to halogenation in the presence of sunlight, that is your HNO. Then ethyl chloride is formed. Ethyl chloride is subjected to reaction with alcoholic KOH, then ethene is formed. Again I will repeat the answer. Methyl bromide undergoes Wood's reaction, then ethene is formed. Now ethene is subjected to halogenation, then ethyl chloride is formed. Ethyl chloride undergoes reaction with alcoholic KOH, then ethene is formed. Now I will do question number 16. The question number 16 is your methyl bromide to acetylene. At first I will write the formula of methyl bromide, that is your Ca3Br. The formula of acetylene is your, that is your CH111CH. At first methyl bromide undergoes reaction with the sodium dry ether, that is your methyl bromide undergoes Wood's reaction, then ethane is formed. Now ethane is subjected to reaction with the chlorine in the presence of sunlight, that is your HNO. Then ethyl chloride is formed. Now ethyl chloride undergoes reaction with the alcoholic KOH. Then ethene is formed. Again, ethene is subjected to reaction with the Br2 in the presence of CCl4. Addition reaction takes place. As a result, 1,2 dibromoethane is formed. Now 1,2 dibromoethane is subjected to reaction with the excess alcoholic KOH. Then acetylene is formed. Again, I will repeat. At first, methyl bromide subjected to reaction with the sodium in the presence of dry ether. Then ethane is formed. Now ethane is subjected to reaction with the chlorine in the presence of sunlight. Ethyl chloride is formed. Ethyl chloride undergoes reaction with the alcoholic KOH. Then ethene is formed. Again, ethene is the undergoes addition reaction in the presence of CCl4 with the bromine. Then 1,2 dibromoethane is formed. Again, 1,2 dibromoethane undergoes reaction with the excess alcoholic KOH. Then ethyne is formed. Now I will do question number 17. So question number 17 is your ethyl bromide to tetraethyl ammonium bromide. The formula of ethyl bromide is your C2H5 Br. The formula of tetraethyl ammonium bromide is your C2H5 4 NBr, N plus Br minus. That is the formula of tetraethyl ammonium bromide. Ethyl bromide subjected to reaction with the NH3. Then ethyl amine is formed. Again, ethyl amine subjected to reaction with the ethyl bromide. Then diethyl amine is formed. That is the C2H5 twice NH. Again, diethyl amine subjected to reaction with the ethyl bromide. Then triethyl amine is your formed. Then triethyl amine again undergoes reaction with the ethyl bromide, gives the tetraethyl ammonium bromide. Again, I will repeat. Ethyl bromide undergoes reaction with NH3, gives the ethyl amine. Ethyl amine undergoes reaction with the again ethyl bromide, gives the diethyl amine. Diethyl amine again undergoes reaction with the ethyl bromide, gives triethyl amine. Triethyl amine undergoes again reaction with the ethyl bromide, gives the tetraethyl ammonium bromide. Now I will solve the question number 18. The question number 18 is your acetic acid to ethyl methyl amine. The formula of acetic acid is your CH3COH. The formula of ethyl methyl amine is your C2H5 NH CH3. Acetic acid undergoes reaction with the hydrogenic acid, that is your N3H. In the presence of H2SO4, heat is given. Then methyl amine is formed. Now methyl amine subjected to reaction with the ethyl bromide. Then ethyl methyl amine is formed. Again, I will repeat. Acetic acid undergoes reaction with the hydrogenic acid, that is your N3H. In the presence of H2SO4, heat is given. Then methyl amine is formed. Now methyl amine undergoes reaction with ethyl bromide. Ethyl methyl amine is formed. Next, I will do the question number 19. Ethyl amine to ethane. The formula of ethyl amine is your C2H5 NH2. The formula of ethane is your C2H6। बीजे सिंपल रिएक्शन इथाइलिन अंडरगोज रिएक्शन विथ इथाइल मैग्नीशियम ब्रोमाइड देन इथेन इज फॉर्म। दिस इज ए वेरी सिंपल रिएक्शन। रिमूव दिस पार्ट दैट इज योर सेड टू बी C2H6 दैट इज योर सेड टू बी इथेन एंड द बाय प्रोडक्ट यू कैन राइट C2H5 एंड NHMgBr। Again I will repeat, ethyl amine undergoes reaction with ethyl magnesium bromide, then ethane is formed. Next I will solve the question number 20. The question number 20 is your ethyl amine to methane. The formula of methane is your CH4. So ethyl amine is subjected to reaction with the methyl magnesium bromide, then methane is formed. Ethyl amine subjected to reaction with the methyl magnesium bromide, then methane is formed. You can write the byproduct like this: C2H5 bond MH MgBr. Now I will solve the question number 21. The question number 21 is your methyl amine to your ethane. So take your methyl amine, that is your CH3NH2. Now it is subjected to reaction with the C2H5 MgBr, then ethane is formed, that is your C2H6. Here the byproduct is your CH3N bond H bond MgBr. Again I will repeat, methyl amine subjected to reaction with ethyl magnesium bromide, ethane is formed. Next I will do the question number 22, that is your methyl amine to methane. So we can write your CH3NH2 and it is your methyl magnesium bromide, then methane is formed. The byproduct is your CH3 bond M bond H bond MgBr. Now I will do the question number 23. The question number 23 is your nitroethane to ethyl methyl ethyl methyl amine. The formula of nitroethane is your C2H5 bond N double bond O coordinate bond O. The formula of ethyl methyl amine is your C2H5 bond N bond S bond CH3. At first nitroethane is converted into ethyl amine by the help of reduction. When nitroethane undergoes reduction, then ethyl amine is formed. Now ethyl amine is subjected to reaction with the methyl chloride or methyl bromide, then ethyl methyl amine is formed. That is all about the conversion related to the aliphatic amine.